Welcome, happy morning, Trinity Church and friends. Today is the Lord's Day, and it is a special Lord's Day indeed. It is Easter Sunday 2020. We continue to be in social isolation in our apartments. Catherine and I have been sharing this Holy Week and the days that leading up to it here, doing wonderful things together, and you all, I'm sure, are doing wonderful things together also. But you are beginning to feel a desire, I'm sure, as we are, to get back into church and to be in regular rhythms. Nevertheless, we know that this Easter presents to us a unique challenge, a unique discipline, and I believe a unique opportunity for us to be Christian community in a new way, in a creative and vital way. And so we are glad that you are here. Catherine is filming this and will be offering the readings today in this shortened service. It comes from the daily devotions for individuals and families. Very appropriate setting for this early morning service. I told friends that if we were to name this service, I would call it Welcome, Happy Morning, the title of a great Easter hymn. If you're following in the prayer book, the structure is a simple one, one page on page 137 of the Book of Common Prayer. We begin with a psalm. The psalm appointed for Easter Day this year is Psalm 118, verses 1 through 2 and 14 through 24. Psalm 118 begins at the bottom of page 760 of the Book of Common Prayer. Page 760. I invite you, if you are reading along in your prayer book, to join me in this psalm. On the bottom of page 760, Psalm 118, verses 1 through 2, and then verses 14 through 24. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His mercy endures forever. Let Israel now proclaim, his mercy endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation. There is a sound of exultation and victory in the tents of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has triumphed. I shall not die but live and declare the works of the Lord. The Lord has punished me sorely, but he did not hand me over to death. Open for me the gates of righteousness. I will enter them. I will offer thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. He who is righteous may enter. I will give thanks to you, for you answered me and have become my salvation. The same stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes. On this day the Lord has acted. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Listen now to two readings appointed for this day.
A reading from Colossians. So if you've been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you will be revealed with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone that sat on them. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has been raised from the dead. And indeed, he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb and quickly, with fear and great joy, and ran to tell the disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. This gospel text, familiar to all of us who have been having Easter Sundays through our lives, perhaps heard new today, as it has been for me as I've reflected on this moment, is rooted in the experience of what might be called social closeness, social connection. The theologian Serene Jones, president of Union Theological Seminary in New York City, and a schoolmate of mine many years ago, has said in a wonderful new book about grace that the whole idea of theology, of talking about, thinking about, and being attentive to the ways of God in our lives, that whole idea must be done in social context. We need to be connected with one another in order to know God. Now, she says that doesn't put the lie to the ideas of a monk on the side of a hill praying silently. But even there, those who are in religious community are connected to each other through the rituals of prayer, the hours being prayed, usually with deep connection to the Psalms themselves, and therefore reaching back to their faith traditions, going back to the traditions of Israel, praying the Psalms in the experience of exile from their temple, exile from their beloved Jerusalem, and yet together, socially connected in a strange land. The psalmist cries out, "How can we sing the Lord's song in a strange land?" But sing they do. And so we who are singing the Lord's song this Easter day in not a strange land, but a different land for us in terms of worship, this cyber land, this Facebook Live and Zoom worship and meeting land, are invited, no, are called to sing the Lord's song in a new way. But you know, that song is still the same song. It's the song that Jesus promised to his disciples no fewer than four times in the Gospel of Matthew, three times each in Mark and in Luke. And in two different ways, using amazing metaphors, Jesus tells of his crucifixion, his death, and his resurrection in the Gospel of John. So when the angel encountered the women who had gone to the grave to simply do what was prescribed unto the law, to care for the body of Jesus, when the angel encountered them, that angel said, "Do not be afraid, for he has risen, as he has promised." God's promises are always faithful. Christ's promises to us, we can always count on in our lives. Even in this very strange COVID-19 time, God is present to those who suffer, to those who mourn, to those who live in fear, to those who are anxious, to those who perhaps are getting a little fed up with this social isolation, physical isolation, and are desiring to rush the time when we can come together again. God's promises are always faithful to us. When the women left, they encountered Christ himself. I think that's the turning point in this story in Matthew, that Jesus himself greets them. And in so doing, he says, "Tell my brothers, tell all those who would follow after me, tell us all that God has a plan for you beyond this place, beyond this time. Go to Galilee, and I will be there to greet you." So on this day of resurrection, we simply go to Galilee, not expecting that it will be any less triumphant, any less joyous, any less real than any other Easter day, with trumpets and organs and choir processions and lilies beyond what we have decorated in our apartment, that Easter day will be true to God's promises. And so we go to a simple song about Sunday morning. It's a favorite of ours here in this apartment, and it just seems to be right for this Easter. Hear Nina Simone, "A Sunday in Savannah." Says amen. Young folks, one bar, Sunday in Columbus.
Let us pray. Prayer for Easter Sunday. Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We follow the form of the prayers of the people on page 383 of the Book of Common Prayer. The response to each petition is, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer. With all our heart and with all our minds, let us pray to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. From the peace from above, for the loving kindness of God, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Bishop Thomas and for all the clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our President Donald and the leaders of the nations and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this city of Columbus, for every city and community, and for those who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For seasonable weather, and for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the aged and infirm, for the widowed and orphans, and for the sick and the suffering, remembering especially all who are hospitalized or under care for coronavirus this day, to those who serve them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the individual prayers and petitions that we have on this Easter Sunday that we offer to God this day. We pray the prayer of thanksgiving for the successful surgery of Mark Cheek. We pray for Lisa Bildner, who is anticipating surgery in a day. We remember Rex Nash and his family, Laurie Tim Prosset and her brother and sister, and all those who grieve his death. Are there other prayers this day? Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for prisoners and captives and all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, remembering especially your servant, Rex Nash, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For deliverance from danger and violence, oppression and degradation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Defend us, deliver us, and in thy compassion protect us, O Lord, by thy grace.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, you have promised to hear what we ask in the name of your Son. Accept and fulfill our petitions, we pray, not as we ask in our ignorance, nor as we deserve in our sinfulness, but as you know and love us, in your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Forever and ever. Amen. Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought us in safety to this new day. Preserve us with your mighty power. Grant that we may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity. And in all we do, direct us to fulfilling of your purpose through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
When our presiding bishop, Michael Curry, was elected in the summer of 2015 in Salt Lake City, he preached a sermon on the text that we heard today from the Gospel of Matthew. He said, "Our job as the church is to go to Galilee, to know what Galilee awaits us, and to go with confidence and trust that Christ himself, the resurrected one, is there to greet us." And so this day, as we continue our Easter morning celebration, let us log on with our cathedral church in Cincinnati. The connection is found on Trinity's website. It's also Christ Church Cathedral, Cincinnati. And the service is at 10 o'clock. It's a joyful morning prayer service that the cathedral has put together over the past several days. Trinity Church has a spot in it. We look forward to being part of that worship together. As we go to Cincinnati in a few hours, and as in our lives we go to Galilee, let us remember that as Nina Simone sang, it's another Sunday, it's another day where the resurrected one is there to greet us, and all creation sings, "Praise the Lord." To the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you this Easter and forevermore.
Amen. Amen.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.